Well, hello there, TriStar CXL fans. It's been a while since you've seen this machine. Now, this machine has been fully refurbished, but it's got some changes and modifications in it from factory original. The biggest one is it doesn't have its original 7.5 amp motor in there. That would be about 900 watts. Instead, it has almost a 10 amp, 1150 watt motor that's in there. I didn't put it in there, somebody else put it in there, and it works very well. So this machine is going to be pulling a lot more flow and suction than what the 7.5 amp motor would have, originally pulled. I have previously done the 10 cycle baking soda and sand tests, but now I want to repeat that with just 2 cycles. So we're going to run this thing pretty wide open. I'm going to have the turbo brush. You can see the little red indicator there. If you have a larger screen, it slid all the way over to the left for shag. That's going to give maximum CFM. And instead of running 3 premotor filters, I'm just going to run 2 premotor filters. And you say, well, what do you mean 2 premotor filters? Well, it's got the HEPA premotor filter in there. Brand new. It's never really been used except for testing. That one's going to fit right over the motor housing. And then I have this Vacuum America Clean HEPA bag. I'm not big on using single ply paper bags. I know people still have them, but if I can get HEPA or I can make HEPA, I'm going to go HEPA. This is actually H10. So I'm not going to run the other third outer bag. I have it, but I just choose to run 2 premotor filters rather than 3. So this setup, the way that it's currently running, should pull about 80 CFM from the nozzle. And that's a lot. And that's probably more than this thing was ever designed for. Something else you should know about this machine, if you go back into my brush roll RPM tests, this one is number one. Practically, when it's warmed up, practically hits just about 8,000 RPM. It's got a super soft bristled brush roll. Try to say that 10 times fast. But it spins unbelievably fast. And if you put your hand on it while it's spinning, it actually hurts. So it's like, yeah, you don't really want to do that. It doesn't gently massage anything. It goes for it. But the bristles themselves are, well, they could even be decades old, but they're very, very soft and very, very flexible. They're very pliable. So I'm wondering how well this is going to do with the 2-cycle test. For the 10-cycle tests, it did excellent. Both of these things were close to 80%, but I wonder, when you're in a hurry and you're just going back and forth a few times, will it really, still do well? Will it be better than average? Wouldn't that be nice for a machine like this old, to be better than average? But remember, whatever tests I get, this is running 1150 watts, not including that. This filter is a little tricky to measure easily. So I want to lift it up so you all can see it. And obviously this is a brand new unused bag and it's very stiff. So I can't get it to sit vertical where the bottom's flat. That just doesn't work. Okay, I am looking at 26.53 grams. Quite the disassembly process here, isn't it? See, we've got sand. The question is how much? I got to carefully kind of refold this bag up a bit so it sits right. Okay, like I guess that would mean like unstable or something like that. Okay, we started out with 26.53, and I'm gonna call it at 29.43, subtract the difference, and we got 2.9 out of 5. So that is, there's the fraction, and that's 58%. And that's really good. That's very good. So 8,000 RPM brush roll and a whole lot of CFM, and also this had a lot of sealed suction as well. I mean, it is really quite tremendous, but hot rodded motor. Okay, so let's move on to baking soda. Straighten out the bag here. You can't really see the baking soda in there, can you? It blends in with the white bag. Oh, got an unstable again. Come on. We must be wiggling too much. Okay. There. Stop. Stop the wiggle. Okay. All right. Now let's see what we managed to pick up. So we started off, or I should say we left off, with 29.43, and I'm going to call it at 36.03. So let's subtract that, 29.43, and that's pretty easy to figure out. 6.6 out of 10, let's move the decimal place, a whopping 66%. So again, that's really fantastic from this hot-rodded CXL. Let's sum up this hot-rodded CXL. Great results all the way around. For sand, two cycles got you 58%. Now my current average is now boosted up to 36%. So definitely it's above average. And if you keep going from two cycles to 10 cycles, you'll end up getting 78% of the sand. Moving on to fine dust in the form of baking soda, two cycles, it scored 66%, and that boosted my overall average for all my machines, non-extracted of course, to 45%, so well above average for baking soda. And if you keep going from two cycles to 10 cycles, you'll end up picking 81% up. So that's really fantastic. But keep in mind, this isn't the 7.5 amp motor. This motor is closer to 10 amps. So this is not representative of the performance of this machine when it was new and original. So it is definitely hot rodded. Anyway, what a great machine that still has, great pickup these days. It's still kind of relevant, even though it's an awful lot of metal and, it's not a bagless machine. But I will say that pushing this turbo brush with its, for what it is, it's high CFM and it's high suction. It doesn't have any wheels in the front whatsoever. So everything just kind of goes thump right down on the carpet and it weighs a lot. You're going to get a little out of breath if you've got 1,000+ square feet to go and vacuum. I mean, you're going to have to, you know, like take your shirt off or change into shorts or something like that. So you want to work out. That's what you're going to use. Okay. Thanks for watching. And let's see, what machine can I use to clean this carpet up with that you haven't seen in a while? Let me see if I can grab something out of the pile. My favorite Chinese cheapy with, I think, 91 CFM and a whole lot of suction. 12-amp motor, lots of agitation. This is one of the few vacuums I've ever purchased totally brand new, and we even have a HEPA bag. See if there's anything left to shake out. Maybe there is, maybe there isn't. Okay, do we have anything? a little bit. Oh, real tiny. Real tiny. A little bit of sand right there, real tiny. And ooh, super tiny amount of baking soda. So small. It's so small, I can't even see it, but I can feel it. So it's pretty insignificant. But there's the sand right there. Time for a DC 35. I think that can handle it. Yep. Okay, that does it. So this carpet is ready to go again. All right, thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more tests.